everyone. This is Shiloh with Pet Grooming with Shiloh, and this is my friend, Hank. He is a St. Bernard, a.k.a. Beethoven dog.
Oh, God.
Okay. Oh, my God. He is, like, extremely tall. Come here. Just to show you how tall he is. He's as tall as me. We are going to give him a bath today and get him all clean and pretty. Yes, we are. So you get to see my wonderful journey of me giving him a bath. Most likely he'll be giving me a bath because that's what he does. So here we go. All right. So, as you can see, I use a table to help him get in and out of the bathtub because there is no way I can lift him. He is way too big. Come on, Hank. Now I'm going to get this table out of my way. I'm using this odor eliminator. It's really great. It's really dilutable, so it goes a long ways. It really helps get rid of that stench of wet dog, and he loves to swim in creeks, so it really helps get rid of that creek smell too. It even helps with skunk odors and fish odors. Dogs are rolling in fish or dead carcass or just dogs that drool all the time and have a nasty odor to them. Like my friend Hank. So we basically just get it all over him. Oh, put your head up. You can see what I'm doing. Smelly ears. So this odor eliminator really helps. And then when you go to use your regular shampoo, it really brings out the scent of the other shampoos. Come on, lift up the paw. Reach all the way down to your paws. Look at those feet. They are huge. Huge feet, Hank. Our bottom's clean. Spin. Come on. Sit. Best way to get a big dog to spin is to have him sit. Sit. Turn their head. Crazy dog. There you go. But if you do have a big dog in the tub and you need them to turn around, have them sit down and then turn their head. Because the dog, they turn wherever their head turns. So just have them sit down, it's easier for them to turn their body. And then just turn their head the direction you want them to go.
Yes, I'll come back to you, then I'll ask what have we done.
Now I'm gonna use my quick relief. This stuff is amazing. It smells kind of minty. But it's really soothing for dogs who have irritated skin or dry skin. With the weather change, a lot of dogs are shedding right now. But it's also really good if the dogs have fleas and they have irritating skin from bites, or if they have eczema, or anything else. There's so much. It just really helps. But it also helps with dogs who have really bad odor, like my friend Hank here. Thought about using the refurbished conditioner, but I've decided to use it's called re-moisturizer. It smells like baby soap, and it's designed to just re-moisturize the fur and help with any itchy problems. Pink doesn't really have itchy problems, but with the soap I just used and the re-moisturizer conditioner, it really goes along well together. So I think I'm just gonna do that. And it is very dilutable. This isn't the bottle that it comes in. It's actually a different bottle. I'll show it to you. So this is what I'm using. It's an excellent product. These two are made by the same company, Nature Specialties. And yeah. Now with this conditioner, you can either dilute it or you can use it straight. It all depends on the dog's skin condition. If they're really, really bad skin conditioned, I'll use it straight. But for dogs like Hank, I'll just use it diluted. It spreads really nicely, as you can see. I barely put anything on him and it's just spreading just amazingly. And this stuff smells so good for like weeks on it. I don't know which way to look. That way? This way? I don't know. So sorry if my eyes are just going everywhere. Okay. shake. Maybe? Yes? No? Hank is ready for his last rinse. He's got a bath. Time to dry him. First, I gotta empty my tub of water. Ugh. So, before I dried him, I had to mop my floor because never use electricity with standing water. Thanks. Always mop the floor before you dry your dog. And I cleaned up the tub because there's a bunch of soap suds in here, so I definitely wanted my tub to be clear of soap suds. Now it's time to dry. And my back. Caught most of the hair and the water, so now I'm going to get him out of the tub and continue to dry him on the floor. That way I get a lot of his area much easier than fighting him in the tub. Yeah, okay. So let's move him. I'm going to get him out of the tub the same way I got him into the tub. I'm going to use the table, let him get onto the table, and then onto the floor. This, but he doesn't need it because it's winter now and there's not stickers everywhere. So I'll show you what I'm talking about. His mom likes him to have nice clean legs.
Thank you. the tail, but I don't really like trailer tail. So just a tiny bit right there. I like his long tail, so I usually leave it. I just clean up the back of the legs. Now I'm gonna clean up this front leg.
Turn your body.
When cutting his nails, I'm letting him hold his leg at a comfortable position for himself. I keep my clipper flush with the pad and just trim off what is necessarily needs to be trimmed. Basically, he has pretty good feet because he's in here a lot, so I'm just basically tipping his nails. Bombing with it going in front. Let's see how he does with the back. Take it to the back. Yeah. on my rag, but I don't pour it directly in the dog's ear. Done. Like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. This is Pet Grooming with Shyla.